Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Cecil Life. I'm Brian Hoagley, your host, hosted by Side Channel. Find us all around the social media, hashtag Cecil Life. Follow me down on LinkedIn or on Twitter for any all the other goodness. It's been a while, I know, but, you know, pretty happy. We're back in the studio, brand new. I'll give a full breakdown some other time, but right now, let's talk about security. One of the biggest things that happened at the end of 2020 that's been a major impact to most of us, or at least made us read a lot more news, was SolarWinds. And that brought forth the entire concept of third-party risk management. Now, I've seen a lot of different means and ways to go about handling third-party risk management, from let's assess everybody to I don't really care. Obviously, neither ends of the spectrum is really a great idea. So I'm here to propose a method that you can take in and, you know, obviously mold to however you want, but it's a concept of a 9-block. And essentially what you have is a area within your organization that is going to determine risk based on a set of criteria. Now, let's say we're going to plot all of our vendors and our requirements into this 9-block, right? This 3x3 graph. If we assess our vendors by certain types of values or criteria, let's say, for instance, the most important, or just for your use case, is the value of that organization or that vendor to your organization. And then let's say, let's go over access to that organization by that vendor, and we will plot that here. Now, this rationale should play out, okay? Those in the lower left-hand corner of your 9-block are going to be vendors that don't have a lot of business value to your organization and don't have a lot of access to your organization. Now, this access can either be access to data, access to infrastructure, access to your intellectual property, to your people, whatever it is. There's some level of access, and then there's the business value component. So what I'm suggesting we do is, you know, instead of treating everyone as if they exist up here in this block, this very, very important block, those who have a high amount of value to our organization, along with those that have a lot of access to the aspect of our business that we are concerned about and trying to protect. Let's start plotting them based on two of these variables. There's other variables. You can make this three-dimensional as well, but just let's take this simple approach. Now, there's a lot of vendors out there that want you to just be in this upper right-hand corner because they sell based on licensing. Now, licensing is going to force you to purchase a number of licenses and then assess all of your clients, your vendors, M&A targets potentially, equally. I don't know if that's right, and it sure isn't cost-effective. So, like in another video, a very early CISO Life video that I'll link right here above, this concept can be applied to help you scale, address, and better manage that risk posture of those third-party vendors. So we know that those that have a high amount of business value and a high amount of access are going to sit up in here. Those that have low down here. Now, what does this mean? Well, there's two components to this concept. One is, and you shouldn't really do these independently of each other, one is actually plot where these vendors are based on your criteria. So go through the exercise, take your list of 10 or 100, whatever it is. You're not going to get away from the fact that you have a lot of vendors, and start plotting where each of those vendors are inside of this 9-block. Now, once you have this done, and this should be done primarily by the, by the business, your information security team, those that own this vendor relationship, procurement, those in IT who understand what the access to these vendors are, that should be done by that group. Security could probably have insight into this, but we don't want to spoil or really skew the bias that we're going to create by doing this. Now, why is that? Because we are going to have a separate 9-block created. And here is where we are going to essentially now, same exercise with our 9-block component, have our high access, high value, low value, high, low access, high access. Okay. Now, within this exercise, this is where your information security team is going to shine. What they need to do underneath the instruction of your CISO or VCISO, or their CIO, whomever it is that's responsible for assessing risk. You do have somebody who's responsible for assessing cyber risk in your organization, right? You want to plot in here, what are your requirements, right? What are the actual security requirements for each of the boxes that are here? This is where we're plotting our vendors, but this is where we want to plot our requirements. Now, the requirements are interesting. Your upper right-hand quadrant are going to be those where you really put on the pressure. This is where we want to instill a lot of diligence, okay? Maybe we're asking for, you know, this is where we want to see who the CISO is in that vendor. This is who we want to, you know, maybe do some type of, you know, assessment on. Maybe we do a site visit, okay? You're going to put up most of your criteria in this quadrant here. Down in the lower left-hand quadrant, you might just ask a series of, you know, 1 to 10 questions, okay? You might not ask anything at all. Do you really care about, as one person gave me a great example, the vendor that's selling you styrofoam cups for your cafeteria? No, not really. But you should be assessing all your vendors to some degree. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to go out, and those that have a high amount of business value, we're going to create the criteria, right, for each. Those that have more access, we're going to create slightly different criteria. Things like looking into what their accesses are, how do they manage and handle their accesses. Now, this is really, really important step. And it's really important to do these things separately, because by doing one over the other or together, you might create a bias or allow your folks inside of your organization to game this, knowing that, hey, if I know what the requirements are, before I plot these vendors, I might push that this vendor is lower in this 9 block in order to keep them from having to be assessed critically. That's not right. Don't want to do that. So, simple exercise that we can do and start applying to our vendor program. And this scales. This works for, you know, one vendor to 1,000 vendors. Again, the reality is you're still going to have to plot and understand each of your vendors. You can't just throw them into some type of magic machine and just say, okay, great, they're going to get assessed and the open source intelligence on them is the end all be all of their security posture. It doesn't work that way. This is actually going to be more allow you to be more cost effective with solutions like that or other assessment platforms, because now you're really only putting the criteria of assessing those vendors, potentially the licenses for that software or that platform to assess, against those that really matter. And we're not applying it to those that don't. So just an idea, thought I'd share it with you. I know it's been coming up quite a bit in our conversations with potential clients and clients, and I know it's a big component out on LinkedIn. Everyone's talking about third-party risk management. So Brian Hoagley with CISO Life and Side Channel. Visit us, sidechannel.com. Follow us anywhere around hashtag CISO Life. And of course, you can follow me on Twitter and LinkedIn below. Appreciate it. Glad to be back. We'll catch you next time. Thank you.